What's up, business builders? Coming at you with our weekly video for the next 4 weeks. Our theme's going to be about the negative effects around the inability to hire. What I have found is that usually you don't take action until you get in a kind of a bad spot, a negative pinch. And so I want to share with you guys the realities, these real things that you guys are going through, what you may go through, and these should prepare you. And my goal is that it gets you in motion. You have to start taking action on some of these things. So nonetheless, let's move right in. Topic number one for this week's video, not being able to fire or let go of people that are poor performing employees. Okay, this is a major negative effect of your inability to hire. So if you don't have any other people, like, you have a certain amount of workload, you have a certain amount of jobs that you need to go service to perform at the level that you want. And if, you know, you can't fulfill those jobs, then you're gonna make less money. I don't think anybody wants that. So when it comes to not being able to let go of people, you don't always know whether someone's gonna be great or bad or good when they first get started. I mean, you can really get good at selection, but sometimes you have to see them work. You have to see them get inside of your culture. And over time, you may see that people develop very big egos or very bad habits, and they don't align with the things that you and your core values and your company culture aspire to be. Your ability to let go of those people is very important, because what happens is when you've got a bad attitude person, a low quality individual who is all basically holding you hostage, right? You're handcuffed because you need the guy to go do the jobs. He does an okay job, but all the side effects stresses you out, makes your work environment nasty. It makes things complicated. Like, these are not great people to keep around. But what I find is that people get stuck in these situations. They can't hire. They're like, well, the guy drives. Like, I need him. And so then they're in control. You're not in control. So being handcuffed with big ego workers, right? That's a huge negative side effect. And you not having control over your business and the people inside your business. That is huge. The other bad thing that can come of this is that those poor qualities then spread through the group. So you got one bad apple, and then the one bad apple makes the whole bushel rotten. Because then what happens is usually those individuals are, there's kind of this alpha dog mentality going on, and that spreads to other people. And you know, then your guys, they're picking and choosing what they will do and what they won't do. Well, I ain't doing that. Yeah, I'm not staying and doing this. And then your processes aren't being followed. Your systems aren't being executed the way that they're drawn out. And so the machine, the blueprint for the business, is not running the way it was intended. Big, big, big problem, right? So to me, this is one of the bigger ones I just hear all the time. You not being able to hire new, fresh, good quality people, one of the biggest problems out of it is that you're handcuffed with the guy or guys or workers that don't really fit who you are as a company. They don't fit you and the brand you're building. And we'll talk about some other really, you know, tough topics the remainder of these weeks, of what this can do to your business, what it can do to you. There's some bad, bad mojo, bad side effects of this stuff. But just keep in mind that when you start seeing that cancerous person, that bad culture just kind of infiltrating your team, that's why it's important to be able to hire, because and train. Not just hire, but also train. Because the longer they stay, the longer they realize they've got you. Because you have standards in the business and expectations, and you talk about those, but then when people don't do them and you don't have any consequences or reprimanding the people that don't do those and nothing happens, now they just don't respect you. They don't respect the system. And that can really break down a team, right? Can totally slow down growth. And it all becomes about me, 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 me. And it's nothing about the team. So again, we're gonna talk about the negative side effects of not being able to hire. So this week and 3 more weeks after this one, I would love us as a group. you know, I know I put these videos, I know you guys are watching them. I know you guys are looking at them. Get engaged. Like, comment below. Like, what are you guys doing? You know, specifically in this situation, you have a bad apple, you got a bad cancerous person on your team. What's your process of getting rid of them? What's your process of fixing the problem? Maybe it's not getting rid of them. Sometimes that's not always what you have to do. But I'd love to hear that. Comment below. Tell me an example of what you guys are doing. How are you handling it? What's the key takeaways? What are the things that you wish you knew in the beginning? Let's comment. Let's talk back and forth on some of this stuff, because I want people to learn. I want people to grow. And I don't want you to be handcuffed, because it's no fun. Seriously. So, all right. I'll see you guys on the next video. Peace.